पल्लवी
यस,
मैम
सो आई
भी
एम रेडी टू स्टार्ट.
सर नाउ विल स्टार्ट विथ सेशन. हेलो एवरीवन, वन एंड ऑल प्रेजेंट हियर, माय सेल्फ पल्लवी पांडे, एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट एसबीएनटी कॉलेज आर्किटेक्चर. आई वेलकम ऑल ऑन आवर ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म जनरेटेड फॉर दिस वेबिनार सीरीज. I am grateful to coordinate this webinar series under a broader focus, landscape design in architecture. I cordially invite everyone, each and everyone present here from different colleges and from different professional areas in this series. Actually, in this COVID pandemic, keeping distancing and safety in mind, we have tried our best to reach out online portal. This series' intention is to explore the ecological knowledge that can inform a design, that can inform design, continuous exchange with ecology principles derived through the research study. Ecology. Design is a cultural action which can be explored through some research. So we tried our earlier two webinars focusing on ecological landscape practice as an ecological approach addressed by architect Paramveer Jhadde, practicing architect in at Baroda. He has explored how practice can improve the landform characteristics and ecological system of the place. Then we have tried our second, we have invited our second guest to introduce decoding rural landscape versus her PhD research on how rural areas are explored and how their cultural beliefs have protected the region. This forward today's webinar. On the same basis, today's webinar we are going to see this on ecological science, site planning, and us. This will be addressed by Dr. Shishir Rawal, a landscape architect and an ecological planner. He will introduce this using examples from research, teaching, professional practice, and activism with important ideas for large scale ecological planning and site level master plan. I would like to take this opportunity to introduce sir. Dr. Shishir Rawal is an landscape architect and an ecological planner by profession. He has been a passionate student and a teacher of ecological science, human ecology and psychology, ethics, and built environment design at scales of square meters to square kilometers. He has over 35 years of varied experience in both the fields, both in India and USA. He has been a faculty member in USA and India and was the head of the Department of Architecture at MS University, Vadodara, between 2011 and 2016. He taught at SBIT Vasat first batch, first pass out batch during 2004-2005. At that time, he introduced the subject to our college landscape design and architecture. Currently, he is serving as a professor of architecture at IPSA School of Architecture, Rajkot. He is also contributing to these disciplines through teaching, research, activism, outreach, engagement, and professional practice. His interdisciplinary firm, SAS Synergy, provides him opportunities to practice patience and courage through this discipline. He is interested in shaking things up to seek and share better perspective and platforms for action and reflection in the built environment. We are very, very grateful for your presence, sir. We are very happy to have you as one of our speakers in this series. Diverse experience and diverse knowledge system. I would like to now call upon our principal sir, Professor Shailesh Nair, to address few words.
Hello, good afternoon all of you. Indeed, I am also privileged to be with Dr. Shishir Rawal at MS University when I was faculty over there. Very good afternoon, sir, and welcome you. I'm happy to have you for this series of webinar, which is organized by College of Architecture, SVIT. And this is the fourth webinar which we are conducting today, and many more to come. As an academician, I have worked on this subject. It is very knowledgeable, beneficial for the professionals and the students. So I feel that, I believe that today this webinar will be very helpful to all of you. Without wasting much time, I invite Dr. Shishir Rawal for his presentation. And before that, I request Taha to present the video of our college.
Hello, sir.
Sir, play the video, please.
Yes, sir. 1 minute.
This is a small piece of our college, which you just want to share it with everybody. After that, Professor Dr. Shishir Rawal will be presenting the video.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, I am giving you the rights.
Can you, my screen is visible?
No, sir, you have to tweet. You have to tweet and just you have done earlier.
Okay, I had not actually tried.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you can start. I also request you to mute your because there are a lot of sound coming. So please mute. Let us microphone you. Rest of you, please mute.
that in addition to people as directly associated with some ways of architecture, there are others, cousin friends who have joined the seminar. I'm grateful.
Your voice is not
coming. I think your microphone will be just a second. Let me just see my face, hopefully. Now?
Yeah, we can.
Yeah, okay. Well, I hope everyone can hear me.
Yes, sir.
I can start the slide with the printed. Together, and today it is my fortune in my time. So the initial title, as you can see, was Ecological Sciences, Site Planning and Us. While making the presentation, I thought that site planning is too narrow a focus, so I changed it to Ecological Sciences, Landscape Architecture and Us. So the goal is to churn up landscape architecture professional practice and education. Hopefully through the schools, so lecture and other fora that are available to us in this great country. I usually do that up front because in the end I forget. So thank you, Professor Shailesh Nair, Assistant Professor Pallavi, and team SVIE, who has worked tirelessly in the background for the last 2 weeks and especially in the last 2 hours to make this public education. Yeah, and I'm grateful to these three other Martin complete that. So this is the outline. We'll be following this outline. What is significant to consider? So that is about the perspective. We have a correct vantage point to understand the situation we find ourselves in. And also having those perspectives, then what ought to matter. So points and principles are discussed. Then how is it done? Projects and processes, what ought to be done? Prospects and question, comment, and answers, perhaps. Hopefully, I will not be excited out of this, but something more than just thank you for your presentation. What is significant to consider? The first thing to consider is to be a child, to have the human dimension sprawling into the land of the part of our India. And again, there are pictures of this kind of things, drainage, water is going on. So this is the broader picture within which we need to look at the scenario and the perspectives from the global point of view. So this is so-called normal world map. And now we can think about how this changes as we look at different issues. So this is the map changes from here to here because it is based on population of countries. You can see how New Zealand and Australia have shrunk. Japan is almost invisible. Japan is there on the right hand side. And Europe is shrunk. India and China, of course, are the big populated countries. But the same thing, when you look at the most gas emission countries, then how the other countries bulge out and how we are also, maybe kuch hoon, we are also going to bulge out because we want to also have development and growth. So we are going to emit greenhouse gases that is part of collateral damage
for the so-called development that we have accepted as the current model for human well-being. Look at how Africa has shrunk.
Sir, we can't hear. I think there is an internet disturbance. Hello.
Hello, ma'am. I guess sir having some internet issue.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. So there is a disturbance coming. So, sir, Vantanitu, can you call me for that?
From where?
Hello.
Ma'am, what should I do?
Sir, you are...
Yes, sir.
Hello. Sir, your voice is very...
Should I call from my cell phone?
No, sir. I think some proper place from where you can get internet access.
Yeah, my internet access is... only I'm using right now.
So you can continue. I think we can hear right now. Hello.
Hello. Pallay ma'am. Should I call Sushir sir? And from from my call, we can hear his voice.
Okay, can if you
hear
that can be possible.
Voice? Sir,
what, sir, we can
what I have experienced with my other online.
Sir, your voice is breaking in between. हाँ सर सर का
इंटरनेट
हाँ सर का इंटरनेट ब्रेक हो रहा है हेलो सर आप यहाँ एक कॉल स्टार्ट करके रख सकते हैं सो योर
वॉइस बोलो
हर्ड फ्रॉम माय फोन
ओह माय गॉश
हाँ आई जस्ट कंफर्म विद द पार्टिसिपेंट इफ दे कैन हियर योर वॉइस
लेट अस ट्राई दैट दैट विल बी स्ट्रेंज
This is
but my
sir this is voice from your call
yes
this is voice from your call Sir, we can hear. It's low voice, but we can hear. It's low voice.
Let's see if you can increase your volume.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. I'm Manit. आपके सबका आवाज मुझे बहुत बढ़िया था. They're trying to increase the volume. Can you hear?
Yes, sir, we can hear you now.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, great.
Yeah.
Thank you. I hope there won't be any further. I'm sorry, the people who are sitting everywhere in the wherever they are in the different cities, they are a lot of patients. And
you can
going to be me on the latest.
Sir, what
is your name? Hobby.
I think there is disturbance, lot of disturbance coming.
Yeah, we have increased the volume.
Okay. Yeah. Now we can hear you.
No, my.
You can mute.
Can you hear me now?
You can turn your video off so your internet will work the only audio.
But I need to see my own slide to be able to speak.
So that you will be able to see. Just you have to click on the second button on the Cisco platform. So we will be not be able to see your video.
Okay.
We will be able to see the slides.
Okay, am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, you can continue, sir.
In between, if the voice goes, please exercise 5 seconds of patience. Sometimes it comes back. This is what I learned from my experience of doing many online things in the last 2 or 3 months. Anyway, so this is going back to our slideshow. This is another world map where the indicator, what is the indicator of what is happening because of the greenhouse gas emissions, for example, or so many other things that are going on. And you can see that the price is being paid by the poorer countries more than any other countries. So what is going on? This data is a little bit dated, so the picture must be worse. But on the left hand side is the world forest pre-industrialization.
The video and voice has gone.
And the right hand side is post-industrialization. 2009. That is the picture that we are having. Look, compare the part which is South Asia and what has happened to Southeast Asia in the last 200 years, which is very small time in geological times. This thing, video and voice both have. Let me. Video is also gone.
Video is there, sir.
Sharing.
Yes, sir.
Should I share? Pardon me.
Your screen we can see, sir. You can continue.
Okay. As long as you can see and hear. Let me go the full screen. Can you see the full screen now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is about the world forest, and we are talking about this slide. A living planet index measures the trends in planet Earth's biodiversity, and the green line is the GDP, global GDP, how it is climbing up since 1970s, and somewhere in the last decade of last century we crossed the lines. The GDP has, and the living planet index, an indicator of planet Earth's biodiversity, has been falling down. Another way to look at this is the overshoot that we are having over the last so many years. So the ecological footprint is increasing, the red line, and the biocapacity is decreasing. Biocapacity is average per person resource supply. So that has been decreasing gradually. And it is important for us to keep those things in mind, because we think that this is out happening somewhere else. No, this is happening in our own backyard. This is happening right here in our cities and towns. And none of these pictures are from any other country. These are from our, these are all from our cities. So on the bottom left, the wildlife habitat areas are becoming more harsh to live in. Suburban sprawl is expanding and the megalopolis are emerging. And architecture profession benefits from this expansion. So we sometimes think that apart from green architecture and LEED certification, what else can we do? Well, those two steps are very important and vital, that architecture profession, building design, are taking, but we must keep the big picture also in mind. So we are exploring urbanization in India and what it does to us. And closer at home also, see that these things are part of our reality. And this is Vadodara, but this could be any.
Hello, Sushil sir, we can't hear again. Hello, sir, we can't hear again.
Ma'am, sir's internet connection is breaking.
So I think Shah sir, you can try what you're saying.
No sir, no ma'am, we tried that. That is also not okay. Connecting.
Okay.
Hello, Sushil sir, your voice is not coming.
So can you hear me? Hello, Sushil sir, can you hear us? Your voice is not coming.
Hello.
I called him. He is going to repeat from this line. He is going to again start with this line.
Hello.
Extremely sorry, everyone. Sissy sir is having an internet issue. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Sir. ફોન થી એક મિનિટ હું પાર્ટિસિપન્ટ ને પૂછી જોઉં એમનો વોઇસ તમારો સંભળાય છે કે નહીં. તમે જસ્ટ ચાલુ રાખો.
હા પ્લીઝ. નહીં તો આઈ હેવ અ લેપટોપ, આઈ કેન મૂવ એનીવેર ઇન માય હોમ. વેરી સોરી.
પલ્લે મેમ, આપ
યસ યસ તા સર
કોલ રેકોર્ડિંગ સુન સર સીસી સર કી આવાજ?
એક મિનિટ.
હા સંભળાય છે.
હા હા સર સંભળાય છે.
હા સર
અવાજ સંભળાય છે. આ રીતે સંભળાય છે.
એટલે ફોન થી ફોન થી ચાલુ રાખું કે સેનાથી ચાલુ રાખું?
સર ફોન થી ચાલુ રાખો.
આ બેટર છે સર. આ બેટર છે. ફોન થી ચાલુ રાખો સર. વી કેન હિયર.
હા વોલ્યુમ બહુ કમ હે. સુનાઈ નહીં દે રહા હે. ક્લિયર હે મગર સુનાઈ નહીં દે રહા હે.
અચ્છા दूसरा लैपटॉप ट्राई करता हूँ.
ओके सर.
अभी अभी बंद करके ट्राई करते हैं मैं बोलने का. ये सेलफोन बंद करता हूँ और ट्राई करता हूँ.
ठीक है सर. ठीक है.
हेलो Hello, can you hear me now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, we can hear you. This is better. Sir, you can speak for a while so that we can check out.
Screen dekhai rahe ho tumaro? Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Screen.
Just sound settings, tumhe off kare do. Haan.
Okay, done. Yeah, we have done that.
And sir, full screen.
Yeah, full screen. Yeah, just a second. Okay, is that better? Can you all hear me now?
Yes, sir. It's better.
Yes, sir. This is better.
Okay. So we are now at the second part of our presentation. Back to you. We have gone ecological science matters. So we are talking about these definitions.
Sir, can you repeat that part, because due to connectivity issue, we could not be able to hear. Sure.
What I did was, this spelling is wrong, closer to at home. We have this kind of scenarios. So urbanization, exploration, this kind of overshoot is happening. And this kind of and urbanization is increasing with industrialization also. And as we progress, we all face the price, but the price is paid mainly by the poor people and nature, the other living beings. So what has all this got to do with architecture or other built environment profession? And we need to think about that, and we can discuss these things later on in the question answer session if we have time. Can you hear me now? Can you see the screen?
Yes. Yes.
Perfect, sir. Go ahead.
What ought to matter? So points. So these are the five things that ought to matter. Ecology, ecological sciences, and system thinking matter. Land matter. Landscape matter. Landscape architecture, ecological planning and design matter. And we matter as citizens and as professionals and educators and students. So what is ecology? Ecology is the science. Ecology is the science of interrelationships. Ecology is the science of interrelationships among and between abiotic and biotic components. And ecology is the science of this interrelationship for the abiotic and biotic components of the environment that we live in. And are constantly, we use and abuse this, shape and reshape this through our designs. So the normal view, the way we have been taught, and the way universities are departmentalized and compartmentalized, is that there will be a department of zoology, there will be a department of soil, there will be a department of hydrology or civil engineering, department of forestry. So we have segregated the environment. The correct picture of the environment is a more ecological picture. It is an integrated system. It is a mysterious ways things are interconnected. The networks, the sun, from sunlight to chlorophyll to all the life put together in the lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere, and what is ultimately called the ecosphere, which is our planet Earth. So this is how we see compartments. We see the compartments as if they are made up of this kind of states. And we recognize China, Pakistan, Myanmar, Sri Lanka, Afghanistan, etc. But these are still compartmentalized. It is similar view to this one, that we see the compartment like this. Similarly, we see the world like this. And it has administrative values. It has certain other kind of values to divide the world like this. But this is the thing that I want to bring to your attention. The nature has not designed the world according to our compartments. Many years ago, in the decades of 70s, Dasman and Udvardi, these are the two researchers working with IUCN and other academic places, they developed this biogeographical realms of the world. And I'm just showing you this realm of the world. While doing this transfer, the Vadodara arrow is now showing us north of Mumbai. That is not correct. Vadodara is actually at the juncture of number 15, number 8, and number 17, which is what I try to tell you that in the list. So this is how we should begin to appreciate that we are not just states and districts and cities, but we are a part of the larger ecosystems and larger landscapes and ecoregions. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is how I understood in the years of my own education. I'm still a student, but when the opportunity came to explain to the students this natural system, well, how does it work? So I want to show you this diagram first and then put the labels. The labels are coming up now. But on the left hand side, from the bottom to top, it is a step-by-step development of environment that happened. On the right hand side, the squiggly lines, the chaos, is something that we are. So this again environment has come. But the climate, geology, landform, water, vegetation, human beings, they are all part of it. So on the right hand side, the squiggly lines are that of the relationships, that is ecology. On the left, the triangle has the components of the environment, but they are interrelated. So it started with climatology and geomorphology and geology, and they two acted together to create another variable called landform. Landform is actually the part where our drama happens. All the built environment professions are working on the landforms. And we do not see much of climate and geology unless it is too humid a day like today. And we do not know how to use this data and how to apply this data to design. So we are going to try to say that ecology is the basis. And from that basis, the ecosystem level, there is ecology, landscape ecology, ecoregional ecology, human and social ecology, restorative ecology, conservation biology, and there is another dimension to human ecology, which is part I'm very interested in, is the environmental psychology. And those, all these things together, when we look at together, that is when the understanding of a designer, not as a problem solver only, but a problem definer. I mean, how, if we define the problem correctly, our answers or our processes are likely to yield better answers. So these are all separate one-hour webinar in themselves, so we are not going to get into the details of these things. But just to show some ecological principles, this is a principle called ecological succession. And unfortunately, what happens is that when the client comes to us, he starts with sab site saaf kar diye maine, compound wall bana diya, aap aake apne design karo. आप जो कुछ भी बनाना चाहते हो हम कर सकते हैं आपके साइट पे हम कर सकते हैं. बट दे डोंट रियलाइज दैट दे वर एट द फोर्थ स्टेज ऑफ सक्सेशन, द फोर्थ स्टेप, बट दे हैव रिमूव्ड एवरीथिंग. सो व्हाट हैपेंस बिकॉज ऑफ ऑल दिस थिंग्स दैट दिस नाउ अ डेज देयर इज एन आइडिया कॉल्ड रेजिलियंस इज कमिंग अप, बट देयर इज अ पैरेलल आइडिया कॉल्ड रेजिस्टेंस. सो इन द सेम डायग्राम इफ आई पुट द लाइन बिटवीन, फर्स्ट थ्री स्टेजेस आर several stages, they are less complex ecosystems. When they are disturbed, they are resilient, they can come back to their original state, these first three steps. But resistant system, if they are disturbed, resistant if disturbed. So if you imagine a rainforest or dense forest and go with your avatar kind of big trucks and all those things to remove the trees, they will offer resistance. So what is important to learn here is that once the right hand side kind of ecosystems are disturbed, they take years to come back. Whereas on the left hand side, the ecosystems are simpler. They do not take, they might take 1 or 2 monsoon to come back to the third stage of development, or 5-10 years to come to the fifth stage of succession. But this is what, when you do site analysis, understand which part of the site is disturbed, which part of the site has potential for regenerating forests. So this is what this science is tell us, the principles, the concepts that help built environment professionals. One of the most misunderstood, one of the most abused component of environment is, in my opinion, the landform. There are 6 attributes I've mentioned here: high point and low points, ridges and channels, elevation, aspects, slope percentage, water gathering slopes, and water spreading slopes. So this kind of class I can take later on, but I have shown in the blue line on the top near letter B is on a, it has changed the location. I do not know why in the PowerPoint. It is, the ridges and channels can be marked, high points and low point mark can be marked. Even if you do not have a topographic map, even if you just have Google Earth map, the darkest green shades, high, medium and low green, if you look at that, it is very likely that high, dense green, dark green is likely to be low point. And lightest sepia, high, medium and light, low sepia, lightest sepia is likely to be the high point of the site. So even with, if architects, architects and students begin to understand how the lay of the land works, how these attributes can be actually mapped, and I'll show you some examples later, then our design can begin to respond to that. Another factor that we kind of neglect is that there are other living beings, and because of our action, these living beings are threatened. They are threatened categories are there. IUCN Red Book created these things, and this is the latest data I found from this site, Endangered Earth. And this data says that there are now 41,000 species in the IUCN list, and 16,000 of them are endangered species. So endangered is already in the middle. They are just going to take two more steps before they become extinct. Critically endangered, extinct in the wild, and extinct throughout the world. So this is the stage where we have reached. And this is the science of landscape ecology. Just to give you an example, and on the right hand side in the yellow boxes are some of the principles. I'm going to keep this slide. So single large is better than single small. So if you want to protect areas, whatever size you might be working on, protect larger things. Single large reserve is better than several small. Several small reserves together nearby are better than when they are spread out. Several small, when they are disconnected, they are worse. When they are connected, they are better. If the reserve shape is obtuse, then it is better because it offers zone and inner habitat. So these are some of the things that are out there. And landscape architecture subjects and landscape architecture program especially need to pay a close attention to this discipline of landscape ecology. Because if we apply these principles, then we are likely to get a picture which allows us to see the patches and corridors in the landscape. And Google Earth images give us a great idea about that. Great understanding about that, even without proper survey that we may or may not have. So the second point is land matters. Land matters because land is life. Land inspires. Land bestows. Land is limited. Land is degrading. So land matters. Landscape matters. Landscape is partnership between nature and culture. As we saw in yesterday's webinar, by Dr. Pate. This is what she was trying to show us, her research work and in her rural studio. So landscape, and what happens is that landscape shapes our experiences. And that those experiences are actually what we carry in our heart, and those experiences mold our mind. Those experiences mold the way we think, the way we behave. And landscape, as a both as an ecological concept as well as a concept at the design level, gives us a holistic perspective. And all this is sorely missing in our haste for economic growth. So landscape matters. And by the way, landscape is a compound word. People have written about it etymologically. Landscape is two parts, land plus scape. And the scape had been earlier defined as view. But it is the old way of looking. It is the old definition which is wrong. Anne Whiston Spurn, who used to teach at UPenn and then at MIT, she has written a book called Language of Landscape, in which she has described how etymologically, in the sense the root meanings and roots and meanings of words, she found from European languages that scape actually meant partnership. So in partnership with land. So what does happen? Landscape architecture and ecological planning matter because these interrelated disciplines, professions have long been accepted and are in demand. So these disciplines actually are bringing this truer understanding of landscape and larger ecological perspective into focus. And we all have a responsibility to learn that and apply that in our work. At all scales and in all sectors. Third part, projects and processes. Can you see the screen?
Yes, sir. You can see the screen, but the slide is same earlier on.
Slide is not visible, right? I do not know why. It is a slide of regional scale, landscape scale, local scale, and detail scale.
No, it was earlier. It is earlier one. Landscape matters.
This slide I'm talking about. Now it is
coming. Yes.
Okay. Yes. So you can see the slide. It took time to load, I think. So this is called embedded nested hierarchies. Things are part of the others. So we might work at this level, at bottom level, at the site level, but site is part of a larger mosaic. It is made up of many different kinds of mosaics, and they come together, and time is a variable in which a change is visible, and all is part of a larger regional landscape. So ecosystems come together to form landscapes, and landscapes come together to form ecoregions. So in this context, I'm going to show you some examples. So continental scale significance. There are this level of thinking, this level of scale and thinking is not happening right now because we think that we cannot make any change. That continental scale intervention are not possible by small professionals who might be interested in saving the world, so to say. But if you look at this is a project called the Wildland Project that began in North American continent, and they are thinking of applying this to a larger scale. So they have the birds, flight routes, the animal migration on the terrestrial part of the ecoregion. So you can look at this from Alaska and Antarctica right up to the middle, some Central American countries. They are having a large vision, the wildland network that they are talking about. And what they are doing is, this second map is a little bit complicated, but you understand. This is shown for the USA, and this is partly shown for the Western USA, the part that is shown on the larger scene. So they are trying to map patches and corridors of vegetation and streams and networks of streams and rivers and all that, so that they can map all those things, and then they work with the community and the farmers and the urban administrators to kind of recreate the quilt, so to say, of nature. In 1980s, the word came, in the early 1980s, urban ecology word came. And the city of Berkeley in California, USA, was the first one to bring about a bylaw, a law, that for any new development on any plot, if there was a, they created a map of their older network of streams and ponds in that administrative area. And they said that the developer has the responsibility to daylight, that is to remove the hidden stream and reveal it to the sunlight and work with that as a constraint. And if I give you an example of the constraint, we all work with that constraint and we don't complain. But when we think about stream as a constraint in the design, then we all kind of say that this is not fair. We need to fill up the stream, to culvert the stream, we need to put the stream in the pipe. I'll show you an example a little bit later of that. But this is at several scales, with local community, with local administration and government. They are trying to envision a picture where continental scale integrity of abiotic structure, not the biotic. The biotic is completely dependent upon abiotic. So when I hear biodiversity is the focus of India for this year and the video clips came out and all that, and I urge you guys, please do not fall into the trap of biodiversity, because what we need is abiotic diversity before we can get biotic diversity. Because biology, or the living beings, human included, are dependent upon the abiotic, that is climate, geology, landform, surface and subsurface hydrology, soil. Those are components that we should not screw up. We should deal with very carefully so that we can achieve this kind of vision one day. So at the continental scale, and this is the principle based on that, how the corridors and patches can be interconnected, even in the urban areas, how this greenery can be, the fingers of green can get into, how right up to our site we can respect some of the streams that might be passing through, and some of the ecologically significant areas that might either they are not there, so we can restore them back. So that is where restoration ecology comes and plays a role. So this is at the continental scale. Then at national significant scale, I know I'm putting only two slides of this because I don't want to focus on this. This could be a separate webinar. But we all have a responsibility to know something more about Central Vista, no matter what your position is. Because this is not a project that is like not going to affect us. Of course, the site is in Delhi. It is in Lutyens, Delhi. But it has so many dimensions to it. And we are not yet ready to even take part in the discourse. We all have our priorities and compulsions, but I think architectural fraternity, at least I can speak for Gujarat, my friends, my colleagues, my students are not actively participating in this debate at all. There is a lot of thing going on out there, and I'll show you the example of that. This kind of posters are made by Lokpath. Lokpath is an organization of assorted, it is not a registered organization. We create outreach posters like this, and it is not against development. Please don't ever fall into the debate of development versus conservation of nature. That is a false debate. It is always, we have so much of knowledge and science that we can have conservation with development and development for conservation. Green architecture shows us that, and we have miles to go in that direction also. But there are other critical issues at policy level as well as at project level. How many of us kind of knew about Dibang Valley hydroelectric dam structure that was going to be built? It is in the remotest part of the northeast corner of Arunachal Pradesh. Because it is so far from us, some few other people are taking care of it, so we don't have to worry about it. In our own corridor, in our own western part, from Mumbai to Delhi, the DMIC corridor is going to come. industrial corridor is going to come. And a vast majority of us are oblivious to these things that are happening. So ecoregional significance. Now from the continent, from the continental to national to ecoregional scale. And some of these things, by the way, this is a part of my activism. I'm not involved with that, but I'm involved with 150 odd architects. I'm also going to be now involved with the draft EIA 2020 policy that is going to impact the entire nation. And I know our BR program cannot tackle everything, but at least we should be aware of what is going on so that when we make specifications, when we make details, we should have in the background of our mind, we should be aware about these kind of things. So at eco-regional significance scale, again, it is part of my long-term activism. This is part of academic work in the USA. One of my students did the work in Ghana, and I'm not showing all her work. This is a typical digital elevation model that is shown here. The bottom is the Atlantic Ocean. And this is part of a very small coastal part of Ghana, where she wanted to evaluate the tourism development potential. And this kind of map tell us the darker blue areas are low-lying areas. This is an elevation map. So at every certain, on the legend, you can see the contour interval at which this color code is done. Another thing, and I'll cite to the students and young teachers, I want to convey, that whenever you do this kind of elevation map, show the lower areas darker and the higher elevations lighter. Many times I go to juries and reviews, even design competition drawings that I've seen of other some firms, they misrepresent this. The lower elevation should be darker and the higher elevation should be lighter in tone. So what was her advisor? What we did was she mapped all the conservation value areas, high, medium, and low conservation values. And this is a raster map based image. So you can imagine that the rating scale was applied. There are various ways to do site assessment and site evaluation. So this is an expert based model and computer data from various systems and cultural systems were brought together to make this map, and then same variables of natural and cultural system variables were same applied to create the second map, development potential. In this case, it happens to be tourism related development potential, but development potential, we are using the same data, but from the development perspective, that what will enable and help facilitate development. So low development potential, moderate development potential, and high development potential. These are the rating scales that are shown here. This is a separate class altogether, different ways from Gestalt to very technical, highly kind of non-linear equation. Use karke bhi hum analysis kar sakte hain, lekin that is a separate thing. I'm just showing you the result of those kind of analysis. So these two maps are created, and now what we do is that we combine these two maps. It is taking time to load on your screen. Just yes, now it is there. So on the left hand side, the variables of natural system, cultural systems, and experiential quality are mentioned. There are things that are mapped. And both set of data are used to create, as I explained you, synthesis level one, the middle vertical conservation values and development values are joined together to come up with significant conservation and development landscapes areas that we can intervene. So this is a detailed part of it, and this lower side bottom table is enlarged here, and these are the recommendations she came up with as policy guidelines based on that detailed analysis of all the three parts, natural system, human system, and experiential quality. When these three things are looked at together, these are the kind of ideas mapped areas. These are defensible processes. Carl Steinitz, who was a chaired professor at Harvard Graduate School of Design, Department of Landscape Architecture, has written a book called Defensible Processes in Landscape Regional Design. So this is what this kind of work has been done in landscape architecture program when I was teaching in the USA. Now, ecoregional significance too, the second example, and this example is coming from my local involvement since 1998. Then it kind of became dormant because I was in the USA, and then it again shot up in 2006, and then from 2006 to 2014. Why this is coming? Okay, so this is about riverfront development ideas. So this slide should come. I don't know why it is taking so long to load. So other riverfront development projects are mostly dominated by engineering solutions focused on single objective and non-inclusive and often benefiting smaller sections of the society. So our Vishwamitri related focus was on glorious past, vibrant future, but celebrating and renewing water bodies and eco-responsible culture by design. See, look at these words, eco-responsible culture. The whole culture mindset has to change. And later on in my slideshow, I'll show you how we were able to do that through the three-pronged approach of awareness, advocacy, and alternatives. So collaboratively develop and economically and ecologically. I'm waiting because, can you see the screen? Can you see our goal?
No, we can't see our goal.
Yeah, it is coming.
It will take time.
Yeah, it is coming. It is coming. Yeah.
Yes.
So our vision that focuses on goal, collaboratively develop an economically and ecologically healthy and experientially rich river watershed and city with water and Vishwamitri as the central value that will attract new creative class and investment for an exciting, mature and harmonious future. There is so much opportunity in ecological approach. It can create new kind of courses and degrees. It can create new kind of jobs. And we do get occasionally the video clips where making reuse of plastic bottles and whatnot. So for Baroda City, we wanted to give a big picture and we wanted to understand and regenerate Vishwamitri River as a system by design. So we wanted to focus on values and opportunity for a saner holistic design that addresses. I'm waiting because it is loading this part. Nature services, ecosystem services, social inclusivity, regenerative economy, cultural identity, and rich experiential qualities. So these were the five things that we wanted to focus on in our efforts. It is a long story. This is just a big map of general location for the people who are not in Vadodara. To Gujarat mein chota sa Vadodara ke Vadodara jisme baitha hai. The Vadodara is part of entirely, largely, like almost entirely sitting in Vishwamitri watershed. It starts from the right hand side. The slide is coming up. So Vishwamitri watershed on the northeast side has Pavagadh Hill. The Pavagadh Hill has many streams coming down, and the streams move towards the regional topography. This map I was waiting for. The streams are moving down the terrain. The first order stream, second order stream, third order stream, all this come down, and then they meet another bigger river called Dhadar, and this is the geomorphic as well as drainage channel map that we need to understand. So a big picture was created. First of all, the big picture of the watershed, green, blue, and I don't know why this is coming up so light. The green, the blue network, and the cultural spots, and the red outline is this outline of Vadodara city. The Vadodara city, and Vadodara city itself is a network of greens, potential network for green spaces, but they are all dumped up. I'm waiting for the screen to show you the map. If it doesn't come, then I'll move to the next one. Anyway, these are the two maps of showing the green and blue network, several ponds. These ponds are interconnected, and these interconnected ponds also serve to provide ecosystem services for groundwater recharge, local biodiversity, and such. This is the green network, and this green network is now threatened. There are several things that are happening. The major thing that is happening is the filling up of the ravines. The ravines are being filled up with solid waste. And though this picture is somewhat dated, you can see that in the right hand side green patch, there is a historic structure there. And this is Vadodara Municipal Corporation daily dumping that happens in the ravines and close to the river stream. So with this reality came the idea that the 16.5, almost 17 kilometers long corridor was largely going to be taken up, and one size fits all kind of approach was presented in June 2014, and since then my local friends and I have been actively working to stop this project, and so far we have been successful. This picture is wrong. This picture is absolutely wrong. In the sense, look at the, if you look at the water body, the river and the green slope, they are showing the, on that peach green slope, they are showing the crocodiles basking there, the plant growing there. I know it was a conceptual design and I should not criticize this sketch, but more importantly, the sketch here also shows, if you look at the black line of the section and notice the three vertical black lines, from the left hand side there are two for creating two promenades, on the right hand side there is one. These are called diaphragm walls. They are 18 meters deep inside the ground, 10 to 18 meters deep inside the ground, and 10 to 18 meters above the ground level. And this is what is called riverfront development project. And Vishwamitri, unlike Sabarmati, is meandering river. It has great habitat. It has endangered species, crocodile and other other species are also endangered there, both plants and animals. And we wanted to do this in a climate like Baroda. Concrete paths, as if trees and birds and crocodiles there to serve us. And this is the criticism, not of the firm. This is the criticism of the idea. We are facing the crisis of conscience. Who are our clients? Who are we going to design for? And that is why we respond to the bottom of next slide. Come up. So this cross section, there are so many things. I can spend half an hour on explaining you this, how this design was conceived and what it did. So if you look at this idea that we can have this cross section for 60 kilometer on one side and 16.5 kilometer on the other, and would have ruined the natural habitat, the microclimatic benefits that we get because of the green corridor going from north to south, by the that Vadodara city is enjoying the biodiversity and climatic benefits There are other ecosystem services that this river corridor provides. All those things were going to be demolished because of this proposal. So fortunately, both the MS University faculty members as well as people from outside came together. We understood the consequences of this kind of design, and we came to with the idea that there could be an alternative. There is a way to come together and create a better alternative that will be responsible and responsive both to the local ecosystems. So this is the diagram. On the top, you can see the river meandering through Vadodara city. On the right hand side is north, on the left hand side is south of Vadodara city. And this is the things that are happening. The most significant part of this particular thing is that we came together. These people who are you are seeing on the bottom, the people had meetings with Vadodara Municipal Corporation. We have people in our group who are zoologists, who are environmental education people. They came together and they created this. And this is on the left hand side bottom, this is the ghat that volunteers cleaned up and participated in making it a happening place again in the community. This is the dirty water is seen on the left hand side. The meetings were several. Even CP people came and communicated with us, and we presented our plans to them. So if you look at this idea that a city who is dumping their waste in the river and rivers, who is allowing large scale development to happen right on the in the ponds. They have shaped a pond that was connected to Vishwamitri naturally, historically, that has been filled up, a huge retaining wall is made, and this is what they are doing here. So when you look at this big picture here, there are animals, there is the way to analyze, the way to unravel natural systems complexity from climate to animals. This is what we need to do, and this is what is happening right now. When we talk with authority, the municipal corporation, we work with them, we attended the meetings called by them, the local activists. And we began to change their mind, and we even offered, as you can see now in this change slide, we tried to work with this, and we tried to offer a alternative, which is ecological planning and landscape architecture based, ecosystem based, analysis based, synthesis based model. So this is not detailed out. This is what could be a win-win situation. We can still have human beings getting closer to nature in selected areas, and we can still have the development that is necessary to happen in the periphery of the river. We can also make lateral connections to the city. There is so much potential out there, and we not only work with the river corridor, but one of our students who did a BArch from MS University, and then she did her masters from the University of Michigan, she conducted a self-initiated master's project at the University of Michigan School of Natural Resources and Environment. Now it is called School of Environment and Sustainability, where I was taught my master's and PhD degrees, second master's. So we also focused on the Bukinala, which is the middle part. Bukinala is a tributary of Vishwamitri River. And though the right-hand side photograph is not from India, these are the kind of eco-engineering measures that we can take at different parts, strategically chosen parts, to based on which kind of erosion is taking place, which kind of degradation has taken place, what kind of restoration we need to create. Based on all that, we can take this kind of bioengineering measures, and we can restore eventually the riverine corridor entirely, and keep human little bit on the side and not impinging upon the habitats of other living beings that are part of our world. So these are some gestural images. One is shown there. So in our Vishwamitri, the eco-regional kind of, not eco-regional, but at least watershed level intervention, we want to, these are the few next steps we want to take, where we will gradually go towards the idea that we can together move forward, and that moving forward requires different actors from government side, different departments, irrigation department, forest department, revenue department, local farmers, all those people, plus experts of various fields. And landscape ecological planning brings together all these kind of different stakeholders in the environment to come up with the idea that a better alternative can be definitely created and can be shaped with certain participation, building upon small projects, collaborative action, and certain degree of confidence, because we are going to make our decisions based on evidence. We must have integrity and humility to be able to achieve this kind of work that is right now only envisioned but can be achieved. So when we think about this idea that we have, just taking time to load the next slide, I do not know why it is taking so much time.
I request some participants to mute the mic. Thank you.
Hopefully we are now going to move towards some specific example of master plan and site plans, and then we'll conclude with few other slides on what we ought to do, what we can do. But in my screen, at least the next slide is not showing up, so I do not know what is the problem.
It is taking time.
Yeah, it is taking time. Sometimes it comes immediately, sometimes it takes time to load.
Okay. It's okay, sir.
I don't know why it is stuck on this. Is there something I can do to make the slide move to the next one? I'm going to do.
Sir, can you press pulse up and down? Page up and down.
Yeah, I'm doing that. It's still showing, you guys, it is still showing the previous slide.
Yes.
And the slide that I can also see on my cell phone screen. And there is a mismatch between what I'm doing on with my laptop and what is being shown in your screen. Should I refresh?
Yes, she says, you switch off your mobile, you on the laptop and it will be better, because in a close proximity, if you're doing that, you'll probably have this issue.
Oh, right. But if I... Okay, I can put my laptop a little bit farther away. And I can keep my screen, cell phone a little bit closer. But I've muted my sound on the laptop.
Oh, there's two connections together. You are having this thing. One, you switch off.
Yeah, that might. Yeah, but there was a volume and sound problem. That is why I started the on the normal WebEx audio video input. I'm waiting. I do not know. I'm so sorry, guys. I really appreciate your patience, and it is frustrating that my gizmo is the latest.
Can you email me the presentation? I will do the changes screen share from my screen.
Just a minute. Let me escape from here. Let me start the email and email you that thing. Just a second.
Yeah.
What are you email karu sir?
Share karu sir.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
It is taking time to upload.
Okay.
Again.
हेलो सुशील सर, कैन यू हियर मी? हेलो
मैम, वो मेल कर रहे हैं मुझे.
मेल कर रहे हैं. तारा सर, देयर इज वन सजेशन दैट इवन इफ देयर इज अ पिक्चर नॉट अपलोडिंग प्रॉपर्ली, सर कैन कंटिन्यू टॉकिंग. देयर इज अ सजेशन फ्रॉम वन पार्टिसिपेंट.
You can call him because yes, he is emailing
me. Emailing. So, okay.
So he's maybe not able to see us or maybe not hear us right now.
Okay. I'll try that.
Can I speak now? Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what I was showing was the Vishwamitri project, and the next one I'm going to show you some examples of the master planning and site planning level work that both my students and our firm SAS Synergy has been involved with. And apart from so in the last 10 years or so, we have been very fortunate to participate in 3 or 4 design competitions at the campus level. So we have participated in IIM Udaipur campus, IIT Jodhpur campus design, as well as one project in Bhutan. And all these three happen to be campus design projects, and we were fortunate that everything happens for some good. We were not able to win any of these three competitions, but we were able to be part of the top 3 firms out of about 10 to 20 firms that participated in that. So when we think about competitions, we think that there are big firms, and usually one single firm doesn't work. Taha, please send me the permission to become the president.
Yes, sir. I have sent, sir.
Yeah, you have sent. Okay. On the my laptop login, I want the.
Okay. Which ID, sir? Can you speak from that laptop because I have to. There are 100 parties.
Yeah.
I
know my. Shishir.travel. Shishir.travel.
One second.
And the email address is INMSU.arch.
Wait.
Shishir.travel.
Shishir.travel. Right?
INMSU. So please send to the INMSU the way I logged in.
Okay.
INMSU.arch. So what I was telling you is that there are three or four campus designs. One government big complex, Rajasso Bhavan. But today I'm not going to show you, talk about Rajasso Bhavan. We were working as a landscape architect in that team. That project also, I think, has been shelved after the change in the government. So now what started was that in a consortium, there is a big architectural design firm. Then there is a firm that is related to green audit related work. And then there is a firm called related to pure architectural design decisions. And okay, are we back?
Yes, sir.
Can you see the screen now?
Yes, sir. We are able to see the master and site plans.
Yeah. Those are the examples I was talking about.
Okay.
So, that part has begun. So, I hope the change will, screen change will happen more efficiently. But it is still not moving. If you can hear from my laptop audio, then maybe I could stop the. Okay, so what I think was that master plan and landscape architecture based on ecosystem and landscape ecosystem. So good landscape architecture emerges from the deep understanding of patterns and processes of nature as well as culture. And they emerge in good aesthetic experience that we can avail through our sensitive approach to site and the users. So this is the IIM Udaipur image. We started with the terrain analysis, the elevation model, and all this mapping is done to identify different parts of the how the natural system works on the site, even how the cultural system works on the site. So these maps were created and they were then put together to create a more synthesis map based on which the program for the whole campus was laid out and strategic landscape, ecological health, land health interventions were also proposed on the site. So when you look at this topographic map, hydrological map, aspects map, aspect is the slope side which is facing east, north, south or west. Usually we use this aspect map to, and especially it was very important in the Bhutan competition, which I'm not going to show today, where the southern aspect of the slopes, Himalayan slopes, become very critical to locate, to place our land uses and public and private quarters of the campus. So those are the kind of this particular way of analysis and this particular understanding of the place that comes from this analysis. And we are not even showing you the vegetation map or the habitat map. We are not showing you the climate comfort map according to this topography. So you can imagine on the outskirts of Udaipur city, these were the images that came out. These were the layers that we mapped And based on those layers of map and synthesis, we very carefully laid out the living waters. Again, it is not changing, right? I do not know. Anyway, so if it moves to the next project, I'll move talk about that, because the visuals are very important for you guys to appreciate and understand what is happening. फुल स्क्रीन नहीं करे आज कल
सर तुम स्क्रीन हटाई देशो ना तो जल्दी थसे लोड
शू हटाई दो तो
फुल स्क्रीन ना करो फुल स्क्रीन ना करो
हाँ हाँ वे
प्लानर डॉट टा सर
बस कॉपी पेंट पेस्ट कर हाँ फुल स्क्रीन नहीं कर मुकल वाम लगे से इतने स्क्रीन पर ये देखा है जो ये क्यों तरह था कि पर हमारा इलस्ट्रेशन इस नहीं आता आई नो गाइस इट इज 6 o'clock एंड यू हैव बीन पेशेंटली वेटिंग અને તમને હું મોકલાઈ રહ્યો છું
ઓકે
ઈમેલ પર મારું પીડીએફ મોકલાઈ રહ્યો છું વિચ સ્મોલર ઇન સાઇઝ એટલા માટે પીડીએફ મોકલાવું છું
ઓકે સર
અને ઇટ ધ ઈમેલ હેઝ કમ ફ્રોમ માય સન્સ એકાઉન્ટ સો યુ વિલ સી ધેટ ઇન યોર ઈમેલ ઇન તહા યુ વિલ ગેટ ધ યુ શુડ ગેટ ધ પીડીએફ
Yes, sir, I have received your mail. I'm just downloading.
Yeah. So, you are going to share the screen, Taha, now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now hopefully it will run smoothly. You need to go to slide number 85.
Okay, sir, just a minute, sir.
I'm stopping my sharing of the screen so that you can share.
I have already stopped, sir, no problem.
Oh, you have stopped, okay. Great, congratulations, thank you so much. Page display, going to page display, yes, full single page view. No, that is the same, so maybe go back to view. Yes, maybe that. Yeah, so can we can work with this also if it doesn't go to the full screen.
Yes, sir.
So based on that analysis that I showed you, this is the synthesis map where all the different factors are brought together and we identify high, medium and low suitability for development and high, medium and low suitability for conservation, restoration and protection. So these two kind of site, the way I showed you the Ghana example, the same process was applied. We also had site experiences. So which view, where sunset, sunrise will happen, all those experiential quality, sensory quality assessment was also partly used, not wholly used. But we came to this synthesis map, and based on that, the urban designer and architects team had kept ready the program, the footprints. So we worked collaboratively to create this footprint that you can see on the bottom left, and then you can see the top on the top right. You cannot see the details, but on top right are the different kinds of land conservation, soil health, wildlife habitat creation kind of measures that we have taken while also considering future expansion. And the red arrow I want to point to your to the people who are still in this webinar. Thank you very much, all of you who are still here. The red arrow on the top right hand side image is what I wanted to draw your attention, that for each site there is water coming in, there's water getting the water stays because of depressions on the site, and then the water also moves out. In this case, water was moving out mostly. So we also considered how our in-site measures are going to be connected and affecting the out of the site, beyond the property boundary kind of landscape processes or ecosystem services. And we were very careful in adopting this. So on the left-hand side, bottom left-hand side, you see the master plan that was submitted by our consortium. And on the right hand side, we can see the image of a particular view that was part of the, that shows both architectural character and landscape character of the place. So we were creating a campus where self-sufficiency in food, water and energy became part of it. So those details, that could be a separate webinar with my partners who had worked on this project. Next. Yeah, so this one is another similar kind of process. This was an old abandoned warehouse for timber warehouse, where the timber processing was happening on the in near Nairobi, Kenya, and it was named by the client Wonder Valley Resort, and the similar process went out. Was adopted, and we created this synthesis map, and based on that different program elements were laid out, and adaptive reuse. We were the architects and landscape architects for this project. We did a lot of work, but because of certain kind of financial issues, this vision was not implemented, and lots of all these paths, movements, the clustering of the buildings, all those that you are seeing, there is a naturopathy center here, there is a Vipassana meditation center here, there is a, on the road on the bottom of the site plan, there is a petrol pump thing, there is a youth hostel kind of camping ground facilities. This is about 100 plus acre site in which we had developed this master plan. Next. This is the IIT Jodhpur campus. Lots of analysis. Unlike Udaipur campus, Jodhpur site was almost flat, but still we were able to get the map done, and landscape ecological principles on the top, bottom, connected corridors, stepping stones were created. On the top left hand side that you can see, the master plan. The green fingers were at the vegetation to stop the erosion in smaller plots. The campus itself was very compact, and the surrounding land on the site dedicated for farming, which were done with collaboration with the surrounding farmers. They will also benefit from it. The IIT campus would have also benefited from it. So these are the kind of efforts that were made in this particular effort, in this particular competition, this particular design competition. So next one. This is significant. This is where I was new to India, 2005, 2006 to 2009, when I was not working full time anywhere. Actually, I was coming for a year or more than a year to SVIT Vasa, their first graduating class. Bhagyajit Rawal and other people were students then, and I was teaching part-time thanks to our late professor Rajan, who had insisted that I should come and teach there. And during that time, I was invited by Suzlon Corporation, and we worked on this Waghodia SEZ. And you can see that the plan above, the right-hand side plan above, was the master plan that was already done before our firm, our small firm SAS Energy, became part of it. What they had done was that in the master plan, if you see, the Google Earth on the left side shows the white line of the, there's a small meandering stream going through the site. And what the master plan had done was they had straightened out and put that into a channel, RCC channel, trapezoidal section. And we, when we entered the picture, we tried, we made four consecutive different kinds of presentation. In the final presentation in Pune, the main person in charge from Suzlon, Mr. Jitu Baitanti, who happens to be a graduate of APIED, but he listened to our arguments, our position, and he agreed that we will restore the stream on the site, even at the loss of some financial money, I mean financial benefits. So this is the bottom slide, bottom right.